Blame it on Dave. The comedic road he paved. The paths of gravel, cobblestone, and pebbles. The weeds, the thorns, the bass, the treble. The temper we temper. Damp clothes, mildew in the hamper, so we air out dirty laundry and call hate what it is. Cancer. I sat on my hands, arrested my pen, censored my candor. But I awoke from my question when Dave provided answer. I just didn't know what to say. Myriad theories of founded conspiracies, allies attempting to align, finally seeing history clearly. But there's a such thing as a numbing pain, suppression as lesson on how to contain. Well, I'm ripping the Band-Aid off slowly. I need to refill each and every sting, every loathsome inspiration that facing oppression brings. Me and this deep voice in preparation to scream. And although tone deaf, I'm committed to sing. I'd include each and every name, but the list is too long for song. And although not for anarchy, I don't care if we get along. Not if that means silence to violence, coddled compliance, asinine alliance, defeated defiance, poison politics, lethargic lies, disproportionate slicing of putrid pies. There's a storm waging inside that a smile belies, so I'll grimace like a menace, display fire in eyes, brimstone in him poem, burning bush in his bars, and completely indifferent to anything that isn't ours. I watched John Wayne as a child, marveled at Ford's cars, both Jake and the Fat Man, Siskel and Ebert's stars. Lifestyle of the rich and dangerous, cops with steel stainless, of George Washington's acclaim with admitting to cherry tree to be blameless, and the aimless wonder of what it takes to make a black man famous. So here, my dear, let me make one thing clear. A black man don't have to be a martyr or a perfect father for me to harbor appreciation for his heartbeat and breath. And you ain't never gonna find a way to legislate to legitimize his death. So expect me to talk loud in public, send back food if prepared wrong, get frivolous tattoos that mean nothing to you, walk along the streets chanting my favorite songs. Be unapologetic and black. Practice Western African spirituality. Oppose all fraudulent fallacies. Occupy my galaxy with my own realities. And never call those murdered in massacres simply as war's casualties. Casually. Damn. Emmett had green eyes. Black Wall Street had greenbacks. So maybe the envy that was green motivated Oliver North to invest in crack. I am too tired to be admired, too human to deal with the inhumane. Don't just convict those who conspire. Tear this system the fuck out of the frame. And don't call them devils. I don't believe in its existence. An odd facade that God would create something so malignant and allow his creation to argue with and be so indignant, or punish descendants of Ham over pigment, not falling for imaginary figments, no white Jesus, not loving my sisters only for their features, referring to ourselves as God and not his beloved creatures. To bless the mic and speak life through speakers. To be neither impatient nor eager. To no longer accept the meager. My diet can't be scraps. My life neither trailer nor teaser. Running as hot as a fever. Reclaiming what was stolen in seizure. What's the call? Free them all. Done struggled too long. Now I'm getting suited for leisure. Blame it on Dave. And don't call survivors brave. Don't tell me who or what saves, and tell Robert Frost I chose the road less traveled. Only this one is paved. Peace.
Real oral tradition in our house. I knew the word griot when I was a little boy. A griot was a person in Africa who was charged with keeping the stories of the village. Everyone would tell a griot the stories, and they would remember them all so that they could tell future generations. And when they got old, they'd tell them to someone else. And they say in Africa, when a griot dies, it's like a library was burnt down.